Come, my dear queen, it is dusk. Let us go and dance by the light of the silvery moon.
Ah, king, you are such a romantic. Where's the moon? It was here yesterday.
Yet again, it has disappeared from the sky. How inconsistent.
Why is that, Appu?
It always changes shape and disappears.
Does it go on vacation?
Does somebody use it as a ball?
Or eat it?
Neena is learning about the moon right now. I'll go ask her.
So the flashlight shining on this side of the apple is the full moon.
And this dark side is the new moon.
Right, just like tonight. We can't see the moon because the sun is shining on the other side of it.
But what happens when the moon is just a sliver or a half a circle?
Aha! I have just the thing to show you. See how as the moon revolves around the earth, different parts of it are visible because of where the sun shines on it? Watch. Here we are today with a new moon, but as it revolves, we get a crescent moon, then a first quarter half moon, a gibbous moon, and finally the full moon. Then the moon wanes, going back again through the gibbous moon, third quarter half moon, crescent moon, and the new moon again.
I guess I get it.
Sure you will. Use the model to help you. I better check on dinner.
Appu! So you heard the phases of the moon too. I hope I can learn them all before my test. Don't worry. We'll all help you. So, it takes about 29 and a quarter days for the moon to circle around the Earth.
Well, it's good to know no one has been eating it.
No, the moon is always up there, but we can only see the parts that are being reflected by the sun.
So the moon doesn't really shine?
The moon doesn't have any light at all. The sun shining on it makes it appear like it shines.
But it's still magical. It's up there, circling us in space.
And it has eight phases. This is the new moon phase, when we can't see it.
Just like I can't see what Nina's doing. Appu, can you use your magic?
So, the new moon we know, next is the waxing crescent.
Looks like someone took a big bite out of it.
Then the, I don't remember.
First quarter half moon. That's half a circle.
Thank you, Appu. Next is a gibbous moon.
A gymnast moon. Like this?
No, gibbous. Kind of a silly word. That's how I remember it.
It's also the moon with only a little bite taken out.
Then is the full moon.
Then the moon starts going back to the beginning again.
Called waning. That next phase is the waning gibbous.
Not gymnast.
Then the third quarter half moon.
Then back to a crescent.
With the big bite taken out.
But this one is the waning crescent.
Meaning it's almost gone.
Then back to the new moon again.
Completely gone.
And this all happens because the moon is spinning around the Earth.
Every 29 and a quarter days.
Basically once a month. That's a lot to remember.
Not if you make it into a dance.
Great idea. Let's make a chant and dance to it. New moon, crescent, first quarter, gibbous, full, gibbous, third quarter, crescent, back to new.
New moon, crescent, first quarter, gibbous, full, gibbous, third quarter, crescent, back to new.
I did it, everybody. I got 100% on my phases of the moon test.
Congratulations, Neena.
Thanks for all your help.
We are honored to contribute to your education.
But now I have a question, Appu.
What's that?
If the moon has phases when it circles around the Earth, does the Earth have phases if you're on the moon?
Good question.
Looks like someone took a bite out of the Earth.
Very gibbous looking.
So the Earth has phases too. And it's very beautiful. It sure is. We've a beautiful blue home.
We dare to